So I decided to keep this hand because we're on the draw, and if we just draw basically a couple lands, we're in business, and we can potentially curve out with a really good hand. Maybe we'll get some pride action going. Get out the bag of Meow Mix. Meow, 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 meow. Oh yeah, turn two cat. Turn one cat, turn two cat, turn three cat. How do you beat that? All the kitties. Kitty, kitty. Bang, bang. Feel like there's so many puns that can be made off cats. What? Rogue Refiner? You gotta be kidding me. It's actually a game designed by Ben Lundquist. I haven't actually played it, but I've seen the box. It looked pretty cute. Not as adorable as my adorable Pouncer, though. Do I attack? Yeah, I kind of have to attack into that at some point. Yeah, I guess I'll trade. Pretty sure they block. Ah, well, never mind. Guess it was a good attack then. Got my little pride parade going on over here. Pride Sovereign and all his pride friends. Case anyone is unaware, a pride is the name for a group of cats. It's like you have like a swarm of bees, a flock of birds, a gaggle of geese. I should not know that one. Pride of lions, pride of kitties. The tower has arrived. Does this mean we get to untap with our Pride Sovereign? I'm thinking it does. They have all the energy in the world, but they can only shoot for three with a Dynavolt Tower. We could. What can we do here? Declaration Stone, attack for 4, 5, 6, 7. Puts the opponent to 10. They probably Dynavolt Tower the Pouncer, and then untap and shoot the Sovereign. Because I'm sure they could get two more energy on their turn. So I think we need to play a cat to avoid that scenario happening. Or we can exert the Sovereign. So I think we attack with a Pouncer and then exert the Sovereign. They can block, exert. He becomes a 5/5. He can shoot down to a 4/4. Yeah, so you can't. Yeah, there's no way to stop us. No way to stop the kitties. This pretty clearly represents exert because we're not attacking with the sovereign. I'm doing it now in case they, do something like draw a harness lightning, or they like kill our guy in response, and then our cat's dead, then our sovereign's a three, and then they tower it. Just plays around more stuff. We weren't really blocking anyway with our sovereign because they could just shoot it down and kill it. I'm guessing since they didn't play a removal spell on their turn, they just don't have one in their hand, so they just don't have Harness Lightning. That's my guess. So we could block, but then like a magma spray on like the pouncer. If we double block magma spray on pouncer, and then they can shoot the tower. So I think we just take it. Your creatures are lifelink, and we're not going to lose from damage, and we could just declaration stone both refiners anyway. So don't think this is a necessary thing to do. We could stone and attack for some damage. They could sack our clue. We could play. If we draw an untapped white source, we want to play the Caracal, because that's basically just a million damage. They would have to tower it. It's only three damage here. So we're going to kill a creature. We go to five. We could just play a Sacred Cat. Yeah, that doesn't really advance our board. I think it's time. So interesting to note that the opponent's line of play was such that they Dynavolt towered on our turn, which means they're not playing around Blossoming Defense. So I think we want to board in Blossoming Defense since the opponent is not playing around it. That's one of the things that you want to keep in mind when you have cards like Blossoming Defense in your deck and your sideboard. Because if they're always playing around it, then you just sideboard it out. But if they're not playing around it, then you want to port it in because it's more effective. Let's see. So we could play the Caracal. So they're trying to Gear Hulk, maybe. Or they're just trying to shoot a creature. The Caracal will at least give us a bonus. We can also Gideon instead. I think it's Caracal, though. Boom, meow. Meow goes the dynamite. With six cards in hand, I would imagine the opponent has something. They have an untapped clue, or a clue that they didn't sack. I'm sure they have stuff. Oh, we got censored. Oh. That was not cool. Because now they can shoot a token. If they have any other way to deal with a creature, this could go very badly for us. Because then they can untap and shoot the Pride Sovereign. So Magma Spray would be really good right here, actually. Suppose if we played Gideon and just emblemed, that would have played around Censor, but Opponent's down to 6, but they have 7 cards in hand. Plenty of mana. It's nice not to have to play around Aetherworks Marvel, though, since there's no way to keep the opponent from gaining energy. Sweet. Okay. Yep. That would shoot our small cat, so we have to get a cat onto the battlefield this turn, which means either exerting or embleming Gideon, I guess, would also work. They're just going to shoot down one of our cats, and the Sovereign's going to be a 3, so if they can just get 3 more energy next turn, they can tower our Sovereign. Ideally, we draw an untapped white source here. Not what happened. Let's see. So we could bring back the Adorned Pouncer. So the opponent has to do something. If we just go Sacred Cat, attack with everybody, we have a 6-6 Sovereign. If they block a 1-1 and tower another the other 1-1, then let's see, it'd be a 6, it'd be down to a 5. That would be lethal, so they have to chump block if we do that, I think. And if they have a Magma Spray, I don't think they let us untap with the Sovereign. They just spray the Sacred Cat and then tower the Sovereign. So we know that they don't have a Magma Spray. Let's play around that. So I'm pretty sure this is just the line. Probably just have a sensor to cycle, something like that. Or nothing. So he goes, well, he could go block, shoot, and go to 1. And then it's got to be a 4-4. Block, shoot. I was going to shoot one anyway just to make our guy smaller so he doesn't die. So then he's just eating the other cat, so I guess it's just this guy. Yep. Well, that's weird. Oh, he's shooting the Sovereign. Derp. Of course. Not sure what I was thinking there. I guess that's okay, though. We got rid of the tracker. The tracker was really annoying. They can't tower yet. They're one short. So, if this Gideon could resolve, or we could do that. I think we want to resolve Gideon, though, an emblem. Yep, that's the cost. So I think we don't have a good attack here. Because they block one and shoot one. Yeah, we're just going to not attack here. Just gonna wait. As if the Gideon could resolve, we're in a lot better shape. That's interesting why they shoot that one. We could just bring that back. I'm not sure what the opponent's line is here. The fee line. That's the line. What's the fee line here? What would you set the fee line at? The over/under on us winning this game. So we could bring back the pouncer. He's got one energy, so if we Gideon and resolves and then we emblem, we're in, like, that's lethal. The opponent could have Torrential Gearhulk now. The Gearhulk for Supreme Will. Now that's a card that they haven't had a good opportunity to cast that card yet. Gearhulk. So we play around that. I guess we could play around that with Adorned Pouncer. And you can't counter that because it's Eternalize. So now they'll probably Gear Hulk and Supreme Will anyway. Just put them up to 3 energy. Oh, Glimmer. Top, bottom. Supreme Will. 4/4 is actually pretty reasonable against this deck, especially when it double strikes, because the tower can't just shoot it down. We could draw planes here, that'd be nice. Then we could go Gideon, Emblem, playing around Supreme Will, and then we could even Declaration in Stone, the blocker, and Flashback Sacred Cat, Embalm. 3, 6, 8, 10 mana. Ulamog? No, they probably don't play Ulamog. Bam, did draw the planes. Do you have a hard counter? Would imagine if you have like Censor and Supreme Will, those are the cards you're banking on being your counter spells. All right, emblem time. So they could Cure Hulk on Supreme Will, cast Supreme Will, counter the stone. So I assume they're trying to block and shoot another one. Yes, we could do it. This does give the opponent a clue. This Dynavolt tower is dynamite. Opponent's like tanking about letting that resolve, so I don't know what they have, but could be like removal spell, Gear Hulk removal spell or something. That is, in fact, likely what it is. Well, we don't have anything, so. Pouncer takes 5 from a Harness Lightning. And one of these cats is about to get killed by a tower. Oh, it was the Gear Hulk. And not sure what they're going to do. Harness Lightning, okay, so they just want to kill all of our creatures. It's a very reasonable line to take. I think the sensor on our Regal Caracal was the big turn of the game. Obviously this turn is pretty big too, but I think that was the point where if that Caracal resolved, I think we win. So we have 1, 2, 3 sacred cats in the graveyard. We do have a Gideon emblem, so all hope is not yet lost, but it does look grim. Ooh, that's cute. We will just bring back the cats. If we can draw an untapped land, we get to play around Supreme Will. Which, interestingly enough, the Caracal is a 4/4 because of the Gideon emblem. So it doesn't just die to a tower activation anymore. Alright, so there are Harness Lightning on our cat tokens. Interesting. Okay. Wouldn't you rather just glimmer here? Seems like glimmering is way better than killing a cat token in this spot. But whatever, what do I know? I'm a white mage. All right, I guess we just cast it. Alright, Essence Scatter, good to know. So that's their other counter spell. Alright, let's see if these do stuff. I think they might. Tower costs 3, I think. Yeah, well, let me see it. So I guess we want Natural State. And since they didn't play around Blossoming Defense, I think that that is a card. I think this card is not where we want to be. What do they have for Stasis Snare? They have Gear Hulk. They have those little 3-2 dudes. Match up pretty well against Serpopod, but Declaration in Stone on those guys. Like, if you kill two of them, it's pretty good, but I don't know. I think I have too many forests. I think one or two of them should be plains. Alright, so what else do we want to cut? So we cut all of our removals so far. We just have Blossoming Defense, Natural State, and a bunch of creatures. If our creatures are dying, maybe the mimic isn't great. Keep. Got that first turn sacred cat every time. It's no Thraben Inspector, but we got some cat synergies. Suppose we could just play Thraben in this deck. Boom. Scratch you in the face for one. Okay, that was a good draw. There we go. Untapped Redland, Radiant Flames. Then we just jam Gideon, I guess. I suppose you can't just let us untap with the Sovereign here, right? Oh, they do. Alright, in that case, I'm not Gideoning yet. I'm gonna play Serpopard. Oh, you're going to counter that? Oh, I don't think so. Yeah, I'm going to have to go ahead and resolve my spell. That'd be great. I think I want to exert the Pride Sovereign as well. On the opponent's upkeep, I think. Okay, look at the top three. All right, I guess I'll do it now. I guess I should have let that resolve and then done it on my end step so that they don't have access to this information that I am going to exert my sovereign, but we'll give you that one. That's a little freebie, a little extra information to make your decision with Supreme Will. Radiant Flames is actually really good right here because it does kill all of our cats. Because it shrinks the Pride Sovereign as well. Didn't have it. Gideon, ally of Zendikar. Boom, victory. So we could have a Johnny. Johnny seems kind of sweet. The 6 mana against a deck that has like sensors and stuff. Just, I don't know. Kind of not on that plan. Like Natural State to deal with the Dynavolt Tower. I like Blossoming Defense because the opponent doesn't play around it and it protects our important creatures like our Sovereign and our Caracal. I think Stasis Snare is a better removal spell than Declaration in Stone or any of these. I guess Prepare to Fight also protects our creature from some things. I mean, they'll just spend 2 more energy to kill it with Arnis Lightning, though. In the draw, we might want to go back to 22 lands. I guess I can cut a forest, maybe an Attune. No, I guess a forest. Yeah, I'll cut one forest, and I'll add back in Mimic. Actually, gonna add back in 2 Mimics. I'll take out a Sacred Cat. All right, looks good. Let's do it. Let's sit in the window and watch all the passers-by. I do not have a one drop. And we might want to cycle it if we draw some more lands, but we're not going to really have an opportunity to cast it or to play it if not, because we're going to go turn 2 Pouncer, turn 3 Pride Sovereign, turn 4 Gideon. It's going to use all of our mana, so I think we just play it. If we draw another land, then a play is kind of bad, but not being able to cast our Gideon on time is worse, I think. Alright, well, it was a calculated risk. Did not pay off. Adorn Pouncer. Cycle the Sheltered Thicket. Okay. The old Animal Shelter. Throw it in the bin. Alright, getting punished. So we play it into the counterspell? I think so, because we're going to jam Gideon the following turn. So if they have the counter, we'd rather them counter the Sovereign and then the Gideon resolves. Yeah. Unfortunately, it wasn't a Serpopard. That's like a Loxodon Smiter. The card is sweet. As long as the opponent doesn't have a Braid in their deck, I think Serpopard's pretty reasonable. But if they do, it's not really where we want to be. Alright, meow meow. Here we go. Don't have the counter. Don't do it. Don't do it. No, no, no. Paying the cost. Don't pay a cost. Ugh. Throw it right in the litter box. Well, the opponent's low on cards, So as long as it's not like a Torrential Gear Hulk and something else important, might be doing all right. Maybe this Pouncer will just go all the way. Just playing around the Supreme Will, just in case, I guess. Now here, if you want to Supreme Will this, I'd rather you do that. And I'll get a Plains. Haven't seen any Magma Spray type cards, so I'm gonna wait on pumping the Cub. All right, they are in fact in Gear Hulk range. But we have the Stasis Nair. Ooh, and there's a Starpa Pard. Piece of candy. No blocks. All right, I'll pump. Oh yeah, got the damage in. Go to nine. What's gonna happen here? Could be Gear Hulk on Supreme Will. Which case we'll just snare it. We could make a token, or we could just jam the Serpapard. If they have like a Radiant Flames, we'll look pretty silly. Actually, that's not true. We'll just pump the Cub and then flash back the Pouncer. All right, deal. Serpapard. Gear Hulk Supreme Will. Yep. This time we're going to do it correctly. Gonna let the opponent make their decision first. The old Impulse Mana Leak split card for one extra mana. We had lethal on board. Refiner matches up pretty well against Serpapard. They're basically the same card, except theirs draws a card, I guess. It's kind of embarrassing. Ours is bigger. The power is bigger. Toughness is bigger. But they just trade. Wait, I shouldn't have F6'd. I might need to pump the Long Tusk Cub. Pump you up. Opponent's playing the Rogue Refiner. We're playing the Rogue deck. Our deck is finely attuned. As is our opponent's. Oh yeah, look at that. Undid the F6. Paid off. So I guess they drew that off the Rogue Refiner. That's the only reasonable explanation for them casting it afterwards. So now we're gonna attack them. Yeah, down to five, then our code would become a 5/5, then we just bring that back to pouncer. Pretty sure that's the line. It's better than making a token off the Abbey. We can start doing that later after this. Question is, do we just pump now? Think the answer is yes. We're going to play the planes in case we need to play around sensor on the opponent's turn. What you gonna do? You got a 5/5 and a 4/4 double striker coming at you. Little black cat. Don't cross my path. Conceded. Didn't even need the blossoming defense. Oh yeah, kitties are too strong. Good games.